So there are two popular measures to summarize the prediction inaccuracy of a machine learning model. So the first is the mean absolute error. So basically, we take each observation, and if we want to assess the out-of-sample prediction accuracy, we would take each observation from our test data set. We compute the difference between our predicted value from our model, the y hat, and the true value of y, and then take the absolute value of this difference. So it doesn't really matter whether we estimate it too high, so we have a positive difference, or whether we predicted a too low value, whether we have a negative difference. Taking the absolute value means all positive or negative differences get the same weight. And then we sum this up over all observations and divide by n to take the mean of this difference. So what it measures, the mean absolute value, is essentially how far is on average our prediction of y away from the true value of y. That's a very intuitive measure. Another popular measure is the root mean squared error, the RMSE. And compared to the mean absolute error, we don't take the absolute difference between the predicted value and the true value of y, but we square it. And that's kind of similar to the sum of residual squares that we want to minimize with the OLS estimator. In particular, if we would compute this for the training data set, then the difference between y and the y hat would be our residual. So here we would have the squared residuals, and summing up over all observations would be the sum of squared residuals. So that's what the OLS estimator minimizes. So, but this is hard to compare summing up squared values. This can be very large values. So we again take the mean, we divide by n, and then the root mean squared error we take around everything again a square root. This expression is actually very similar to the standard deviation of our residuals. So usually both criterion have the same ranking. So often if a model on the test data set has a lower mean absolute error than another model, it typically also has a lower root mean squared error. So it depends a little bit on taste which criteria you want to use. Personally, I think the mean absolute error is easier to interpret, but the root mean squared error is probably the more popular criterion because also it's kind because you have the square here, it really puts larger weight on very large deviations. So if you are for one observation you have a very high prediction error, then the root mean squared error really tends to penalize this a lot. And then the idea is we really want to avoid some very large prediction errors. And if you also have this in mind, the root mean squared error might be the better criterion. But usually it doesn't matter so much which of the two you use.